Okay. I spoke about an avid film watcher. I spoke about someone who's enigmatic. I also spoke about somebody who is a harbinger of sorts. But then I didn't talk about a beautiful lady. Okay, she's that.
Thank you very much.
What's between you?
What? You're talking about me.
She's that and more. But we want to get to know them more. I have Chioma Ude, who's the founder of AFRIFF in the house. Wow, it's great to have you. Great to have you. There's so much. I know the time will never be enough. But before we go talking about AFRIFF, just let us meet as much as we can of Chioma. Okay, so let's meet Chioma. Who is Chioma?
Fun-loving.
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 Easy-going.
Easy-going.
That's about it. Very hardworking.
Very hardworking. I would hold you to that because I saw an article on you and it was like, the quick rise of Chioma Ude. So it was like you came in the industry and a few opportunities, you took them and you were up there. So what was the process? How did you get up that fast?
I don't think I took opportunities. There was a gap. And whenever there's a gap, somebody fills it in. Mm. I just worked hard at what I like to do. And when you do that, then I put my all into it and carried everybody along.
Okay.
You can't do anything by yourself, really. Mm. If you do it by yourself, you go as fast as you would want to. If you go with a lot of people, then you would go faster. Mm. So it's a journey we're all taking. We know where we're going, and we're going to get there very soon.
Okay, how did you birth AFRIFF? I know, let's go from the inception. How was it starting?
Festival? From Chioma. Chioma to AFRIFF.
She said it was just about Chioma. That's what you got. We can't see so much about her. But then, okay, let's go to AFRIFF. How was it from the inception of AFRIFF and all of that? How was it starting AFRIFF?
How it was starting AFRIFF?
Yeah.
I would say it was, I'd like to say it was easy, but it wasn't that easy. Mm. I'll tell you why.
Okay.
I had great people backing me. I had done a film festival that traveled. It's called the Ion International Film Festival. It came from LA to Nigeria, and I locally produced it. Mm. When it was over, the commissioner at the time in River State, his name is Marcus Nleji, he says to me, you know what? You did so well. You have great people skill. Chioma, go and get your own. Come, I'll help you.
Wow.
So I said, what do you mean I'll help you? This is a lot of funding. He says, I'll give you the funding.
Wow.
At the time, my mentor is and was Toronto Douglas because he's dead now.
Okay.
I called him and I said to Toronto, look at what Marcus said. What do you think? And he goes, I'll back you.
Wow. Just like that.
I'm with
great.
You. You know, that's you can great. Do it. He gave me all the encouragement in the world, which he's very good at. Mm. So the first year wasn't that bad because I had somebody who wanted to help me with it. So it was just about getting around the industry. Of course, everybody normally is very suspicious. And then, you know, talking about your intentions and what you want for the industry. Mm. And so that grows as they see how genuine you are or not so genuine. Mm. Yeah. So it wasn't that difficult. Okay. When you do something you love, it's not that difficult.
Wow.
Okay, the phone lines are open. We're talking African films. We're with the founder of African International Film Festival. Mm. And the numbers are open 08091222283456. Also 0814000283 and 4. Whatever questions you want to ask, you can call in and ask. Okay, so let's talk about, let's go African films and all of that. What is it about African films that made you decide that, look, let me push what we have here? Because actually, there are many of us that are not convinced by African films.
Oh, wow. You said many of us, so you're not convinced.
Speaking for himself.
Exactly.
I don't want to say so, but then.
But there are a lot of Nigerians, I will tell you that. No, I don't do Nigerian movies. I don't do African movies.
Let's,
I only do
yes,
foreign
let's
movies.
See. What is it about African? What is it that Africa has to offer?
Mm-hmm. We have films. Very, very genuine stories to offer.
Okay.
You know, I'll tell you what, in Hollywood, there's a quagmire right now. They don't have these stories anymore. They're repeating themselves.
Hmm.
The stories are coming out of Africa. Africa is the frontier right now for film because we have genuine stories. So I have people call me from wherever, be it Europe, America, and you find their main focus always being scriptwriters. They want to know the scriptwriters, they want to train the scriptwriters, they want to talk to, they want documentary because they want our stories.
Okay.
So I tell you what, we have very genuine stories right now. They're just as nitty gritty as it can be. And this is it.
We have genuine stories, but the industry is not as big as the the ones we see out there, this benchmark has been set. Yeah, we have great stories. So what is stunting the growth of African film industries?
I wouldn't say the growth is stunted.
Yeah, I wouldn't say it's stunted.
I would say the growth is actually super fast rising. But we need to get better. So we need trainings. And that's why my CSR, my main focus, has always been on training. From the inception of the festival till date, even when we didn't have funds, we still maintained our training classes. It's free. We brought in all the facilitators from either America, South Africa, or Nigeria, depending on what field we're training at the time. And we train these children I call them children, and the people, my staff always says, oh, they're not kids. Okay.
So we train these they're young adults. Industry, so they're children.
Exactly, exactly. Mm-hmm. And so there's a focus on training for us to get there. We don't have the type of equipment they have. We need to have that. I need to see how I can bring in these companies to have leasing companies in Nigeria. That would also help. But I'll tell you, a lot of people in the industry are exposed to the equipment. They're exposed
yes.
to
yes. Is it who they yes. are? I don't want to. It's about let me go a little bit specific without training any shit at anybody. I was watching a director of a very popular movie at one time, and he made mention of using an Arri Alexa. Now, as at that time, the Arri Alexa was used to shoot Avengers, and he said, this is the same camera that was used to shoot the Avengers, and then the poster of the Avengers came forward, and then the movie that he shot now came up. Okay, so I'm going to mention the name, Last Flight to Abuja. That's the movie I'm talking about. And it was a lovely drama. Now, but I think there was some uncharted terrain which the movie got into, which was effects. Now, they made mention and spoke about the equipment that was used for this particular movie. I know this movie was all about effects.
Yeah.
And it was the Last Flight to Abuja, and then we saw the flight scene and all of that. You see, that was just my point. For me, that really put me off, because I was thinking that if it's a drama, we have wonderful stories, like you said. We have wonderful drama. But then, we want to go into effects. Now, let's talk about moving into effects when it comes to movies and all that. If it's going to be done, it should be done well.
You have to consider funding. It's not cheap to make a movie. And especially a movie that has a lot of effects. So I would shy away from movies that have effects. And, we have to work. We have to pace it. We have to pace ourselves to get there. You don't talk about Avengers and then do that and then... The minute you start talking about Avengers, then your expectations for the rest of people are very high.
That was my point, exactly.
So, but that's a personal killer. I'm not saying the movie was killed.
Exactly.
I'm just saying.
Right, but the production was not so bad after all.
No, I don't think it was.
Let's look at Africa. I know you're not supposed to. Yes, I know you're not supposed to, because you were supposed to be on top of board. Yeah. And you have a film festival. You pick films. They get awards and all of that. Do you ever get to talk about your favorites?
Yes.
Okay, let's talk about your favorite movies.
I have two movies right now. Okay. One hasn't been shown. It's going to be the closing film of the festival.
Okay.
Right. It is beyond awesome. And it's a festival movie.
You got me. No, let's just leave it at that.
I skipped two.
It's beyond awesome. Okay. It's a movie that keeps you thinking. It's a festival. You know, there's a commercial movie and there's a festival movie. It is a festival movie.
A festival movie. What's different?
A festival movie.
Before you still talk about the movie. What's the difference between a festival movie and a commercial movie?
A commercial movie has elements in it that want to make you go to the cinema to watch it.
Okay.
A festival movie is normally deeper, keeps you thinking, and you're like,
Have you seen Birdman, man?
Birdman?
Yeah. A foreign film.
Is it old?
Michael Keaton. No, it's last year.
No, I haven't.
Okay, but I was trying to look, because I know there's movies that have so much critical success and not enough commercial success. So I think that's where we get to the line. When you have that critical success, when you have movie buffs, when you have, those reviewers.
I have more than two movies that I have so many.
But what's the name of this movie where you're talking about now?
Road to Yesterday.
Genevieve's movie.
It's the director's movie.
Okay.
The director is Ishaya Baku. Genevieve starred in it, but I think she also wrote it, which is fantastic.
Wow. Yeah.
You would love it. I loved it so much that I watched it 2 days ago, and I'm ready to go back to the cinema and watch it. And at this point, I'm going to say, yes, I know what happened. Because I was thinking, it seems easy. It's easy on the eye, and then you begin to go deep into it. You know, it's a good movie.
So second one.
Okay.
Second
meeting. One. The meeting.
The meeting.
Oh,
the meeting.
Whoa,
yeah, are you serious? You love that movie?
I actually absolutely loved it. You know why?
Okay.
It's a Nigerian story. You want stories that would sell in Nigeria, that would connect to everybody. So, you have the movies of that would travel, hopefully.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But you have African movies that are for us. You see it, you feel it, you understand it. I mean, I used to go to Abuja and look for contracts and all of that.
Exactly. Well, it was quite good.
It was really good.
Was
October 1st was also good.
Nice.
October 1st.
I think October 1st was almost on the commercial side, too, because it got a lot of attention.
And Kunle is something else. He's just a little whiskey that just knows how to commercially sell anything.
Anything. That's great. That's
He's
great.
Good. He's very passionate. Very, 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 very passionate.
Okay. Just those three movies.
No, no, there are others, I'm sure.
Okay, talking about movies, do you foreign? You do foreign movies? You watch foreign movies? Do you still?
Yeah, of course.
Because as you know, there's some people that stick and like, look, I'm Nollywood and all of that, I'm all African. Mm. And then, but then you still do.
You have to expand your horizon.
Exactly.
You can't just say, you know, I'm here. If you like movies, you like movies.
Okay.
And if you want to take this industry to the next level, you have to know what the gaps are.
Before you go on, Jerry, let me just mention, you said about. You said about moving this industry from. You see, now the thing is that a movie goes into the cinema. There's a movie show I host. It's called Top 10 Movies, and we speak about movies in cinemas. They're apart from 30 Days in Atlanta.
Oh, which I love.
Nice.
That was really funny.
And October 1st, for a short while, there is no African movie or there's no Nigerian movie that has stayed more than 2 weeks.
Oh, that's not true.
Take my word for it. Okay.
Hold on, I'll tell you.
Okay, in the cinema, more than 2 weeks.
Please.
It's true. That.
No, I mean, apart from this once.
I'm telling you another one now.
Because now.
And I haven't so mentioned it as a favorite movie because it's old.
Okay.
But it was a movie I also enjoyed.
Okay.
EJ.
EJ, okay.
EJ stayed in the cinema.
Okay, that's what I'm saying. Apart from a few exceptional ones, a movie comes up 1 day, 2 days, and all that. Now, I'm not good. That's not what I'm talking about. Now, you find out that there's a plethora of what we call this Asaba movies and all of that. That's when we get to see most. We see Chelsea versus Liverpool, which is Sharon Stone.
Mm.
We see some very, very funny names. And those are the ones that are
everywhere.
Proliferated everywhere. We see more of those ones than these high-class movies. And so our perception or our judgment on African movies is made from these ones that we see, the ones that we, that, you know,
Okay, so you want to make money when you make your movie,
okay.
Correct?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Nigeria is a country with 150, 160 million people.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What do they want? The first thing you do is your research. Who is really watching? Your attention is divided. You're watching, what's the movie you were talking about, this TV series you were talking about here?
Maybe a foreign series.
Yeah, so you're talking about watching this, watching that, and then you have 2 minutes for the Nigerian movie.
Yeah.
And I have people in Onitsha who will sit down and watch that in Nigerian movie. Of course, from beginning to end.
Wow.
We have the Yoruba movies that are so captivating.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We need the numbers. You're not the number.
Of course, I'm not. Mm-hmm. Of course.
So when you start getting the overly intellectual movies, then you've lost a certain crowd. And I'm not saying that they're not intelligent, but that's not what they're looking for.
Yeah, they want to laugh, they want to cry.
Exactly.
Drama,
don't you think that's where most of the cinema movies go to?
Mm.
Yes.
So are they not so overly for a particular kind of audience?
Yeah, yeah. So when you do sit down and want to make your movie, you first of all think, who is going to be my audience? So for people that want to travel, like Kunle, like Mildred Okwo, like now Ishaya Baku, I mean, you have to create something different.
Mm. Mm.
But let me tell you what's funny. You go to South Africa, and that's not what they really want to watch.
No.
They want to watch those movies you're talking about.
Whoa.
You go, I went for DIFF. I'm a partner with the Durban Film Festival, and I'm talking to them. And there's this movie, I think Blackberry Girls or something.
Blackberry Girls, oh my God, Blackberry Babes.
You're kidding me.
Wow.
You gotta be kidding me, really.
I haven't even watched it, they were asking me about Blackberry Girls.
Whoa.
So those type movies, okay?
Okay.
Well, nobody asked me after the October 1st and stuff like that.
You are kidding me.
Whoa.
No.
Whoa.
So you have to understand what your audience wants.
Okay.
Demand dictates supply.
Exactly. Right. So now you want to capture the bourgeois.
Okay.
Then you create the movies for the bourgeois, and then you say, okay, how many of them are going to watch this movie? How much am I going to make? Mm-hmm. I tell you what Kunle does, and he does it very well. He makes movies that that resonate. So there's October 1st. Mm. Okay, that's our Independence Day. That's a catch. He works it around that. Mm. So now you're going to watch it in schools because there's something to it.
You're going to watch it in banks
because there's something to it. Mm-hmm. So he's now going beyond commercial and also bringing in another sector to watch these movies. Mm-hmm. So you have to sit down and do your math and decide where you want
what
to
you
go.
Really want to do. Just one more, please. Really, what's AFRIFF about? I know you can put in your movies, you can get your movies to the competition. I want to know about the scholarships, the dates, when is it
very
happening?
Fast, everything about it.
Okay, November 8th it starts. It starts with the opening night movie called The Mediterranean. It's a really, really, really good movie. It's an Oscar nominated African movie.
Wow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Whoa, okay. Now that would make me want to watch out for it.
All right. Okay.
Yes. But the director is also Italian, so. Uh-oh. He's Italian.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
Full stop.
And then when the movie is over, we have Jazz Night.
Okay.
You know, this festival is the most vibrant film festival in Africa, so it's a lot of fun also.
Okay. All right.
So we have the Jazz Night, which will be at Fahrenheit. Okay. It's a cigars and jazz.
Okay, all right. Of course.
So how can people participate apart from
you register? Register online.
Okay, social media, AFRIFF.
Yeah.
AFRIFF social media. How do people get in contact with AFRIFF?
Oh, that's horrible.
What's the website?
www.afrif.com.
Great.
That's it.
Thank you very much. Okay, so we've had a wonderful time with Chioma Ude, the founder of AFRIFF. I wish we had so much time, but then we have to go. It's been a great show. See you tomorrow. It's our FFF edition coming up tomorrow. See you there.
Plus Halloween. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Crazy.
We wish we had longer time.
Yes. You guys should come there.